Well, hello everybody. My name's Kifa, I'm a professional makeup artist, and welcome to my YouTube channel. Before we begin, I first want to say happy birthday to my amazing, wonderful, beautiful niece, Kayla, who just turned 16. Yay! Kayla, this video is for you. I sent you a special little present, which you should have in your lap right now. It should be a beautiful, sleek, black box with the letters MAC in white for MAC Cosmetics, the company that I work for. Inside that box are products that I know you'll love and would look beautiful on you and that would be easy to use. So that's essentially the point of this video, is that I wanted to make sure that I took the time, since I'm not there to be with you, to explain and tell you about all the wonderful features and benefits of the products that you have in your lap right now. And for those of you who may be watching that aren't my niece, Kayla, don't worry, you can still take advantage of this video too. Okay, let's get started. So, that box should be in front of you. You can go ahead and open that box. And if you'd like, go ahead and press pause on this video so that way you can get everything situated and the video can kind of be in sync with your experience. Pause. Now that the box is open, I know that you're just dying to just dive in and see what's all inside, but just hold your horses, let me walk you through everything so that way I can make sure I'm a part of this experience. Underneath all the MAC logo tissue paper, you'll see in the box is the signature small rectangular MAC makeup bag. That bag has a black on black patchwork jacquard print, and it's one of my favorites because it's really cute, and it has the chartreuse lining inside with a little pocket. There's plenty of room to like put any of the stuff that you already have, including the stuff that you're getting today. So inside that beautiful signature MAC makeup bag, the first thing I want you to pull out is the mascara. This particular formula is called Extended Play. This formula is one of my favorites. Sometimes like bigger mascara wands may not be the best for really separating, lengthening, and defining your particular lashes. So this is why I chose this one. The color is called Endlessly Black, and it's a lightweight, it's a curling mascara, it also is a lifting mascara, and it has more of a glossy black finish. And the brush is kind of what's really special about this. It's a slim line brush. So that brush is gonna allow you to get all the way down to the root of your lashes and then separate every single one of your lashes as you pull the brush out to lengthen, add lots of dramatic volume and definition to each and every lash. And the other amazing benefit of this particular mascara is that it has a 16-hour wear. It's smudge proof. And the last and I think most important key benefit to the Extended Play mascara is that it's a tube forming mascara. And if you're not familiar with what that technology means, it means that like with your lashes, as you kind of coat the lashes all the way around, the product kind of creates a seal or a tube around each lash. That's how it makes them look fuller for one. But also, that's also what kind of helps the smudging not happen, because they've kind of created these like flexible little lightweight tubes around your lashes, and it's really easy to take off. So with waterproof mascaras or other long wearing mascaras or just mascaras in general, we all know that at the end of the day, one of the things that's kind of like the most annoying sometimes is really properly like getting all the product off your lashes. So with these tubes, they're really easy to remove. All you need to do is take a cotton pad or a cotton or a tissue that's damp with like warm water, and all you're gonna do is just like gently kind of hold it and press it on your lashes a little firm, so that way you can make sure that the water is kind of doing its job, and then hold it there for like a minute or so, and then just lightly kind of rub off, and you'll actually see the tubes come off like onto the tissue or the cotton, like they're just like slipping off, kind of like when you take off your socks. So that to me is a huge benefit, because you're putting a lot less stress on your lashes for something that's so long wearing, it's really easy to remove. So the next product that you're gonna see in the makeup bag is one of my personal favorites. Anybody who knows me knows how much I love this next product. And it's called the Penultimate liquid liner pen. It looks like... It looks like this. You'll have it in front of you. It's really fast and easy because you don't have to dip the brush or the applicator back into a well. So if you want to know more about this, then I encourage you to watch my past video on kit essentials, because this is one thing that I think everybody should have, and I love this so much. Now, the third product that I want you to pull out of the bag is going to be your best friend. This is the Pro Longwear Paint Pot. It shows a color called Groundwork. So this is going to go on and look really soft and really natural. It comes in a glass jar like this with the lid. It's a long-wearing product, and it's a cream-based product that is anti-caking and anti-smudging, and it won't like separate on your eyes if you tend to get a little greasy or oily right here. This particular product is really cool because one function of this is that it's kind of like cream eyeshadow. You can lightly blend like a sheer wash of this on your eye, call it a day. It's done. It's beautiful. It looks smooth, it looks polished, and it kind of opens up your eyes and it looks great and it's long wearing. Also, you can mix it with things like pigment, or you can use it as a base for your eyeshadow. If you put a little light wash of this on your eyes first and then go ahead and do your eyeshadow, it's going to make your eyeshadow last longer. It's going to make it look better. It's going to help with blending. It's just going to just give that extra oomph that kind of elevates how your eyeshadow is going to look. Everybody should be using an eyeshadow primer to do eyeshadow because it just makes a huge difference. And this is pretty much, if you ask most makeup artists, paint pots are the way to go. We all use them. It's a favorite. They've been around for a while. And it's long-wearing and easy to use. So now we're getting to the really good stuff, the really fun stuff. You're going to see two kind of like square boxes. And inside those boxes are customized eyeshadow quads that I've chosen for you. The first one we're going to talk about is what I'm calling the natural eyeshadow quad, or the neutral one. I specifically chose these colors to work with your skin tone. So like I said, I customized and chose these colors for you. They can be refilled, so if you run out of one or it breaks or like whatever, just let me know. I can always send you another refill for it, or we can always change the colors later on. The first shadow on the top left, Naked Lunch, is just gonna kind of look like a dressed up kind of soft, glowy version of skin. It's kind of a staple. I think everybody should have it. Like a good pair of nylons, how like it just makes the leg just look kind of, there's like a sheen and a glow and a flawlessness to it. That's kind of how I think of Naked Lunch. The second color on the top right, that color is called Saddle. Saddle is like a staple crease color. The color that kind of like goes like right here in the middle to give dimension to your eyes. This particular tone is going to look really pretty on you. It has a really nice kind of warm, almost like terracotta brown undertone to it. So it's really going to bring some warmth and light and like dimension to your eyes and work with pretty much any other shadows that you want to put on your eye with it. The next color is the bottom left, and that color is called Woodwinked. This is like hyper real skin. It's almost like your skin through like an Instagram filter or something of that nature. It's gonna look really natural, but with a more kind of slightly smoky, dressed up feel to it. And the last color in the neutral or natural eyeshadow quad that I made for you is called Espresso. I've been using Espresso for years. This color is just one of those things that I can't live without. It's a great one because there's so many uses for it. You use it as a soft liner if you apply it with like a liner brush, or even like a smudge brush. It's a great thing to have to kind of blend into the outer corner of your crease to add extra dimension, or even as a crease color. It's a great eyebrow color. I mean, I would even use it on my eyebrows too. So it's gonna just be like that kind of darker, soft brown that gives a lot of definition without looking too heavy. And now we come to the last thing in my birthday gift to you, my dear. It's gonna be the second customized eyeshadow quad that I made for you. This one I'm calling the purple quad. I chose this because, I mean, okay, your mom, my sister, loves the color purple. Not the movie, but the actual color. This is going to be, like, more of your trendy palette. So when you're feeling a little sassy, or when you just want to be a little bit more made up, or if maybe there's a special event, I made it to work in conjunction with the natural palette. Mix those colors up. Use one from here, one from here. It's meant to look amazing together and look amazing on you in however whatever combination you choose to create. The first color is going to be the top left one. Trax is like... Trax is amazing. A soft kind of mauvey purple with a little bit of a gold shimmer. It's amazing by itself. Just kind of do a little blowout of that, like starting from here and just kind of blending it out. It's going to look beautiful. And the second color in that purple quad is the top right, and that is called Beautiful Iris. It's just an amazing kind of really wearable, like glowy lavender tone. So now we're coming to like probably like my all-time favorite eyeshadow color. The bottom left color is called Sketch. I talked about Sketch in a previous video, the same video that I talked about Rapid Black. This color, I can't live without it. If I could eat it, I would eat it. Sketch, when I'm doing makeup looks for photo shoots or for customers or whatever the case, it's just such a beautiful, dark, like warm plum tone that works on any skin tone with any other color combination. I wanted to make sure that you had like my favorite product, and I know that it'll look beautiful on you no matter how you decide to use it. And the last color that you're gonna find in that purple customized eyeshadow quad is gonna be the bottom right color. I know that your mom's probably like drooling and probably even asking you if she can have this palette, especially because of this last color. Indian Ink is super pretty, and it's a MAC store exclusive color. You cannot buy this color unless you go online. You can't buy this color at the Macy's counter, the Dillard's counter, the Nordstrom counter. It's only found at a MAC store, and it used to only be found in a MAC Pro store. So it's really kind of exclusive and it's really special. It's a beautiful, like, deep purple, and that's the color that you'll use if you really kind of want to have that little extra glamour, if you really want to just kind of be a lot more trendy with your eyes. So I wanted to give you something a little special, and that is Indian Ink. So yeah, that's the special collection of products that I chose specifically for you, my baby girl. Things that I know would look amazing on you, and things I know that you can have fun with, and that are easy to use. You will see that there are four sheets or four strips of paper. Those are especially made just for you, based on the things that I gave you. For the natural and for the purple, there is a soft look, as well as something a little bit more smoky and dramatic. That way you can kind of have a range, and then you can yourself experiment and create looks that are in between. The natural soft. First thing you're going to do is you're going to take your groundwork paint pot. Do encourage eventually that you apply the paint pot with a brush. It'll just save you from wasting this. It'll also save the product from getting like contaminated or ruined or like dirty or like whatever. If you use your finger or a brush, just blend a little bit of this groundwork like all the way across the eye. You just want a nice like sheer wash. And you can see like with even on like my skin tone how natural it looks, but it still like does a lot as far as like making the area look smooth and bright and polished. If you wanted to like stop here and just have that as a look, good to go. It's beautiful. You can just use it as an eyeshadow. It's great. So we're just gonna take a little bit of Naked Lunch with an eyeshadow brush, something flat and firm. And we're just gonna press, we're gonna lightly press like on the lid. And you see how that kind of just, it looks smooth and still like natural. I'm just gonna blend this out a little bit, but yet it's like a little brighter and just gives the skin a nice glow. So Saddle is, you know, like I told you, is an amazing staple kind of crease color. We're gonna take some sort of like blending or crease brush. And don't forget to tap your brushes after you gather eyeshadow. That way it removes some of the excess. That way you don't get a lot of like fallout down here. And we're going to lightly blend the Saddle. inner crease, back and forth, kind of like a windshield wiper motion. And then softly kind of whisper it upwards towards the brow. So that way it kind of blends and it's nice and soft. Now the next thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna take espresso and we're just gonna add a little bit of dimension. If you wanted to stop here, like I said, if you wanted to stop here, that's great. That's good to go. I'm just showing you kind of like some of my signature looks that I developed for you. So I'm gonna take a soft blending brush with the espresso, and I'm gonna just pop in a little whisper, like right on the outer corner. Soften that up a little bit. And that just kind of adds like a little bit dimension to the eye, really kind of like accentuating the shape and adding some depth. So that way it just looks a little bit more polished. With a smudge brush or a liner brush or whatever the case may be, we're just gonna add a little bit of the espresso on the outer corner of the bottom. Just to kind of add like some dimension to it, instead of like doing liner all the way across, I find that that's kind of like enough, just to kind of balance out the eye. And the last thing is taking the Rapid Black, we're gonna take the Rapid Black. You see how easy it is to use? And it glides on so smooth. And there we go. We're gonna move on to the more dramatic and the second eye chart that I created for you for the natural palette. And we're going to put that on our lid. The same way we did with the Naked Lunch, but just a different color. And now we're gonna go ahead and take Saddle again. And soften that up. We're starting to get something that's a little bit more on the smoky side. So now what I'm gonna do to kind of make this look a little extra special is I'm taking a little bit of the Woodwinked with the same brush that I did the espresso on the lid. So I'm taking some Woodwinked and I'm just kind of pressing it over the lid and just kind of blending it up. It's gonna give it a little glow, but still kind of keep it like more of that natural, soft, smoky look. You can take some sketch and make that even more dramatic just by doing my little trick where I'm adding the sketch to the outer corner just to add more dimension to the eye. So you can see with the eyes, they're completely different so far, but they still look natural and they still look soft, and they're still with the same palette. So we're gonna go ahead and finish this look off with some liner. And I'm gonna take some of the espresso. You can use the Rapid Black for this look if you want, but on the chart, we're just gonna take some espresso and just lightly define the eye. So little smudgy back and forth motions. And then a little down here on the outer corner. One good trick when you're doing mascara is pull the middle lashes out, and when you get to the outer corner, have them like fanning towards your ear, and the inner lashes going towards your nose, and it'll create more of a fanned out lash, something that's a little bit more like eye-opening. So now we're gonna talk about the eye charts that I created for your more trendy and purple eyeshadow quad. For the first chart, it's gonna be what I'm calling the purple, like, soft look. So what we're gonna do now for the softer purple look is we're gonna go ahead and take Beautiful Iris, and we're just gonna lightly pat that on the eyelid. And then we're gonna go ahead and do my favorite little signature trick. Pop a little sketch in the outer corner. I went ahead and I added the liquid liner. Now we're gonna move on to the more smoky version. My Indian ink is in the Rick Baker palette. It's this color right here. Boop, 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 boop. So then we're going to first take the saddle, and we're going to go ahead and do the crease. You can blend a little bit onto the Indian ink and then blend a little bit up towards the brow. We just want it to be super soft. We don't want any like hard lines. We want like nice smooth transitions. And then we're gonna take sketch and go over that. Windshield wiper motions back and forth. If you wanna get fancy, and this isn't on the chart either, you can always take a little bit of black and kind of do my little whisper on the outer corner. If you want to make it even more smoky and more like dimensional. And you can always take like the rapid black, or you can take a black eyeliner pencil if you want to finish this off. I don't mind like doing a smoky eye with a wing liner, or a smoky eye with a smoky liner. If it works, work it. So I just took a little bit of a black eyeliner pencil, and I lined my eye and a little on the outer corner and just blended out so it was soft and smoky. So there are the two different purple looks. There is the soft purple, and here is the smoky purple. Well, so there you go, my dear Kayla, my wonderful niece. Happy sweet 16, happy birthday, and I hope you have a lot of fun playing with all these new makeup toys that I gave you. And, you know, don't worry if you don't get it in the first try. It does take a little bit of practice, but I know that you love makeup, and I know that you do have some experience already, so I'm not too worried about it. If you have any other questions, feel free to call me, text me, email me, whatever, and you know that I'm always here for you. And Uncle Xavier and I love you very much, and hope you have a wonderful birthday, and we love you. Enjoy. For those of you out there that were just watching out of curiosity, I hope that you learned some stuff. I hope that you go and pick up some of these amazing, wonderful products, a lot of which are my absolute favorite that I've been using for years. I'm always one to encourage creativity, the love of makeup, the love of all things beautiful and artistic. So I hope that you have fun, and please stay tuned for more videos to come, and subscribe, and thank you so much for tuning in.
Prima donna girl, yeah. All I ever wanted was the world. I can't help that I need it all. The prima donna life, the rise and fall. You say that I'm kinda difficult, but it's always someone else's fault. Got you wrapped around my finger, babe. You can count on me to misbehave. Prima donna girl, would you do anything for me? Buy a big diamond ring for me? Would you get down on your knees for me? Pop that pretty question right now, baby.